Hi everyone, this is Swetangini Naik from UCP Engineering School. I'm a lecturer in biotechnology. So today topic is RDNA technology. We are going to learn about the process behind RDNA technology. So recombinant DNA technology, that is RDNA technology, is used to produce different artificial DNA, through the combination of different genetic material, that is DNA from different sources. And this RDNA technology was first experimented or first performed by two scientists, those are Boyer and Cohen, in the year 1973. So basically RDNA technology is also known as genetic engineering. But to perform this RDNA technology, we need to go various steps. So what are the steps? Let's see. So first step is generation of DNA fragments and selection of desired DNA. And second step is insertion of desired DNA into vector. Third one is introduction of RDNA molecule into host cell. Then next one is multiplication and selection of clones. And finally, the final steps of RDNA technology process is gene expression. So let us see what is the exact process behind this RDNA technology. You can see this diagram here. First, we need to select our desired DNA, and after selection of desired DNA, we need to isolate that particular desired DNA from the source through restriction enzyme. We need to cut that desired DNA from the source by using restriction enzyme. Here we can use restriction endonuclease enzyme, which are also known as cutting tool. After cutting the desired DNA with the help of restriction endonuclease enzyme, we got our desired DNA. Then we need to choose a vector, which is here I have chosen plasmid, and that plasmid part also we can cut that plasmid by using same restriction endonuclease enzyme. After cutting, we can go for joining. For joining, again we need another enzyme, that is ligase. So the joining of desired DNA with vector is known as ligation, and that can be occurred with the help of enzyme ligase. So here the cutting portion of plasmid DNA, you can see the cut mark which is forming a gap, and in this gap we are going to put our desired DNA. After after ligation, we will get the recombinant DNA, one new combination of DNA that you can see here, that is our RDNA molecule. After getting RDNA molecule, we are going to introduce, the next step is the introduction of RDNA molecule into the host cell, that we have done here. This is our recombinant DNA molecule, and we introduced it into the host cell. So basically here host cell is any bacteria cell. Specifically the frequent use of E. coli cell as a host cell. We can use the E. coli as a host. So here this is the host cell. Inside the host cell, it has already its genetic material, which I have shown like this. And this one is our recombinant DNA molecule. So we have introduced our recombinant DNA molecule into the host cell, preferably in E. coli, Escherichia coli bacteria cell. Then after introduction, the bacteria cell has the special feature to multiply the desired DNA molecule, to multiply the recombinant DNA molecule. The multiplication occurred inside the host cell. That exactly what has happened here. So we got, that is what cloning of our RDNA molecule. After cloning, we can go for gene expression. That is all about the process of RDNA technology, that is recombinant technology. So this is all about our today's topic. Thank you for watching.